Welcome to your morning announcements. She can see it in your eyes. She can see it in your smile. You lack the information Herman wants to deliver. She needs a haircut, but that doesn't stop her. She wants to connect during online school. And she wants to tell you so much. She misses you.
Good morning, everyone. Today's Friday, May 15th, and you are here for announcements. I will do the prayer today. Today is the Interfaith Day of Prayer for Humanity. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. We beseech God the Almighty to safeguard the entire world, to help us overcome this pandemic, to restore security, stability, health, and prosperity, so that once this pandemic crisis is over, our world may become a better place for humanity and for the human fraternity than ever before. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. All right, birthdays for today and this weekend. Today's birthdays, senior Margaret Medini and sophomore Robert Wong. Tomorrow, Saturday, May 16th, sophomore Alexandra Weedy, freshman Calvin O'Connor, sophomore Delaney McGrath, and freshman John Paul Snell. And Sunday's birthdays, senior Anna Gonzaga, sophomore Stephanie Melby, and seventh grader Chase Yoakum. Happy birthday to each one of you. I hope you have a wonderful day. Some quick reminders. The Amazing School Song Challenge submissions are due tomorrow, May 16th. The Virtual Art Show submissions are due Wednesday, May 20th. Today's weather. Today is predicted to be a top 10 weather day, according to Channel 4 Weather. High of 73 with sunshine and a mix of a few clouds. Get outside and enjoy the beautiful day. Today in history, May 15th. In 1536, Anne Boleyn, the second wife of Henry VIII, was beheaded. In 1618, German astronomer Johann Kepler discovered the third of his planetary laws, the harmonic law. You should know that from physics. 1869, the National Women's Suffrage Association was formed in New York City by Susan B. Anthony and Elizabeth Cady Stanton. Las Vegas, Nevada was founded on May 15th in 1905. In 1928, Mickey Mouse made his first appearance in a silent film, a film called Plain Crazy. In 1940, brothers Richard and Maurice McDonald opened the first McDonald's restaurant in San Bernardino, California. In 1951, AT&T becomes the first U.S. corporation to boast 1 million stockholders. After a used car salesman named Brady Denton purchased 7 shares for a whopping $1,018. And in 1991, President George H.W. Bush, a huge baseball fan, invited Queen Elizabeth to an Oakland A's Baltimore Orioles baseball game. I don't know the score. Quote of the day, and this is from the book called The Power of Positive Leadership. This is an excerpt about leading when things are difficult. No matter what anyone says, just show up and do the work. If they praise you, show up and do the work. If they criticize you, show up and do the work. If no one even notices you, show up and do the work. Just keep showing up, keep doing the work, and keep leading the way. Lead with passion, fuel up with optimism, have faith, power up with love, maintain hope, be stubborn, fight the good fight, refuse to give up, ignore the critics, believe in the impossible, show up, do the work, you will be glad that you did. True grit leads to true success. And the joke of the day, I of course didn't get this at first because my lingo for texting is not great. A mom texts her son, "Hi son, what does IDK LY and TTYL mean?" Think about that for a second. He texts back, "I don't know. Love you and talk to you later. The mom texts him back. It's okay. Don't worry about it. I'll ask your sister. Love you too. Have a great weekend, everyone.